Well, 428,000 ADP reporting the private payrolls in the month of August rising by 428,000. That's less than half of the forecast for ADP of 1.17 million jobs were expected to be reported today. And if you look at the bottom of your screen, it's less than a third of the about a third of the expectation for total non-farm payrolls to be reported Friday by the BLS. Whether or not it's something to be worried about, we'll talk about that in a second. They revised up June payrolls. Goods, those are okay numbers in normal times, 40,000 plus on goods and 389,000, but maybe not good enough when you have a whole lot of people who are unemployed in the millions, almost the tens of millions. Looking at size by sector, small business lagging behind medium business, lagging behind large business. Maybe too soon to say, but if you had a couple months of this, you'd say this is what's happening with the differential between what's happening on Main Street and Wall Street, with big companies doing better, better access to financing, better access to government aid, and small business, the aid running out there. So perhaps that's a reflection of that. We'll wait to see a few months if that's the case. Looking at it by sector, professional business services up 66,000, education and health. They may be picking up some of the return to school here, up 100,000, trade transport 58,000, construction doing quite well, up 28,000, finance activities up 11,000, information services was down. So guys, they're saying this is a reflection of a slowing of economic activity. I will tell you, ADP did a good job. The numbers are running around like crazy, and forecasting jobs has now become much more art than science, if it ever was either. But they did a good job in April and May of forecasting it. They've done very badly in June and July. So this is sort of, as you might, Becky, the rubber match in terms of getting, seeing if ADP is doing a good job reporting it. Consensus has not been much better. In other words, the Wall Street consensus has not done a whole lot better. With all of these kinds of fluctuations that are orders of magnitude of what we usually have, it's been very difficult to forecast the job numbers.
And so, Steve, nice, absolutely positive number, but behind expectations, as you just mentioned. But also a nice revision upwards for June, which is encouraging. Just mentioning as well that the dollar slipped a fraction and the 10-year yield slipped a fraction as well off the back of this slight miss. In terms of that sector breakdown, just going back to that, education, as you said, we can kind of understand why that stood out. But what about other sectors? And we talked earlier in the show about the strong manufacturing numbers. Did that play out in any way?
I'm going to scroll just a second here to the sector. There it is. Manufacturing up just 9,000. That's sort of on the weak side, given the number of manufacturing jobs that have been lost. And it reflects, by the way, Wilf, the ISM employment index, which also showed that it's still contracting. So that's not doing well. You did have a nice rebound in leisure and hospitality, up 129,000. I guess that's not on your screen there. But still, millions of jobs lost in that sector. I don't know, Wilf, what your sense is, but I feel like in the job market, you can't say it's a V-shaped recovery anymore. We've had several strong months of rebounds, but still, the numbers are we've still lost 15 million jobs still remain unaccounted for in terms of not being brought back.
And unemployment rate, which we'll get more details on Friday, still in double digits.